Good morning everyone. So in the previous video we have seen subroutines, okay, the call instructions, L call, A call and return instructions, and we have seen few examples on these subroutines. So this program regarding using a subroutine, there is a small delay program. Okay, that delay program is written separately and you're calling it. Okay, based on that we are having this example. So once first we'll go through this question. First just read the question properly. See, write a program to toggle all the bits of port 1 by sending to it the value 55h. Okay, 55h once we need to send to, sorry, yeah, first I need to send 55h to port 1. After that, again I should send AAH to port 1. This is continuously I need to send. I should send 55H, then after that I should send AAH, then again 55H, then again AAH. So in this way continuously I need to send. This is the meaning of the first line. Read again, write a program to toggle all the bits of port 1 by sending the values of 55 and AAH continuously. Okay, after that the next thing he has given is put a time delay in between each issuing the data to port 1. So this data is given to port 1, this also is given to port 1. Okay, first I'll give this, then again I'll give this, continuously I should keep on giving this data. But here he is mentioning another thing is I should have some time delay between each. That means here I should insert some delay and here I should insert some delay, because see, first I'll send 55 into this port 1. After sending, next I should have some delay. Okay, it should wait for some time. It is waiting for some time means that port 1 is still having 55H itself. Okay, it need to wait. After waiting, that is what I'm giving here delay. Then again I'll send AAH. Then after certain delay, this P1 will be equal to AAH. After this AAH, again what I am doing is I am giving a delay, because after AAH again 55 need to be sent to port 1, right? So I need to give some delay. After sending this 55H, again I need to send AA, because he is asking us to send continuously here. So after 55 again with some delay I'll send AAH. Okay, so here see, this 55 and AA I am repeatedly sending. So instead of sending repeatedly, we know that we can use a loop. Okay, so after AAH, I'll give a delay and I'll send back to 55. I'll jump here to this 55H. Again, I'll have some delay, then AA, then delay again 55. In this way, this loops continues. Okay, so now this delay program is written at some other location. That is nothing but I'm calling, using this subroutine, using this A call instruction or L call instruction, I'm calling this delay program. I need to write it delay separately. And here one more question is, he is directly asking to send 55 and AAH, see, into port 1, and he said write a program to toggle all the bits. What does toggle mean? It is nothing but on and off. Okay, the LED to my port, if I connect LED, okay, see, if this is my 8051, if I have a port 1 here, I have 8 3 4 5 6 7 8, okay, total I have 8 bits in this port 1. Okay, so here if I connect one LED here, one LED here, then here, so total 8 LEDs if I connect. Toggling means at when I send 55 means, see, in my port 1 if I send 55, 55 means it is nothing but 0101010101. Okay, that means, see, this is D0 bit and this is D7th bit. So D0 bit is 1, so this will be in on condition. Next D1 bit is 0, so this will be in off condition. Next D2 bit is 1, so this will be in on condition. Similar way, this will be in off, on, off, on, off. Okay, that means this is called toggling. Okay, see, on and off, on and off, on and off. If this happens only one time, we can't say it is toggling. Once I send this, after that, next time, this is for 55. Okay, hexa value, if you convert into binary, this is the value which will be inserted into your port 1. Next is asking us to send AAH. Okay, so when I try to send this AAH, just check the values what I will have. So AA means, if you convert into binary, you will get 10101010. So when you had 1, that is having 0 here. When you have 0, it is having 1 here. Okay, so now whatever were in on condition will become off. Okay, and whichever were in off condition will become on. That means alternatively, once this D0 and D2 and D4, this even ports are being even port bits are being in on condition and odd port bits are being in off condition when I send 55. Okay, and when I send AA, whichever were on before, the even bits of port 1 were on before, that will become off, and the odd bits which were off before in port 1, that will be in on condition. So by this on and off, this keeps on goes when I send it continuously. Okay, he mentioned here to send it continuously with some delay. If I don't give a delay here, just see, if I don't give a delay once when I send this, and then immediately if I send this, when I don't send a delay with your eye, you can't just see that when it is being on and when it is being off. Okay, in some fraction of milliseconds, it will be on and off. You can't just view with your naked eye. So that is the reason we are going to give delay in between. If you don't give delay, you can see all are in on condition only. Okay, because with certain amount of milliseconds of time, okay, microseconds of time, that will be in off, on condition and off condition. So you can't notice when it is being off. Okay, so all will be in on condition if you see like that. But in case if you give some delay, that means at this position, my port 1 will be for certain time, whatever we mention in delay. Okay, so till that delay time, it will be at this 55. Port 1 will be equal to 55. That means this alternatively, there will be on and off condition. And after certain delay, again, I'll give AA. Okay, so that time, this will change. Whichever we are in on condition will go to off, and whichever we are in off condition will come on to on condition. So that time, we can notice AA because again, we have given here delay. If you don't give here delay, again immediately, if you don't give this immediately, that will become to 55 again. Is that fine? So again, you can't notice whether which are being in off condition and which are being in off on condition. Okay. So that is the reason it is necessary to give delay in between so that we can notice when is it toggling or not. Okay. Even if I don't give delay, practically my program is correct because I can't see whether my LEDs are glowing, I mean toggling or not, but internally they will toggle because the program is correct. But if you give delay, you can notice with what time delay it is being on and off. Okay, so that we are going to write a program on that. So yeah, second line, put a time delay in between each issuing of data to port 1. Next, this program will be used to test the ports of 8051 in the next chapter. Okay. That we will see later. So you should understand the question first. So for that, first what should I do? In port 1, I need to send 55. After that, AAH. But in between, I should have some delay. Okay, so first we will see that program. Delay program, we will see later. See, first, I am starting at origin 000H. At that location, I am starting. Now, first, I am writing this move. Move A, comma this 55H. I am trying to load A with 55H. After that, I will move that A to port 1. Okay, this two lines are done. After sending that, now I'll call the subroutine called delay. Okay, so this delay subroutine is written separately at some location. Okay, this is written at CSUM 300 location. Is that fine? Yeah. So yeah, this I'm calling this delay. This delay program we'll see later. Okay, this program first we'll see. So now we have called a delay. That means it will create some delay over there. After P1 is loaded with 55, it will create some delay. Now after that, after giving a delay, I need to load AA. Okay, so when I load AA into that, I need to send AA into accumulator, then I am sending accumulator to this port 1. Now this AA is loaded into port 1. After that, again I should L call delay. okay, I'm again calling the subroutine delay. So this I have called. After that, what is the program? If I write this, that is not enough, because once 55 is loaded, I called a delay, then AA is loaded, then I called a delay. But here he mentioned continuously I need to send that. So to send that continuously after this L call delay, I am writing here short jump back, again this line will be executed. After AA, again 55 will be called if I write this here. Okay, so here see, here this line jump S jump back. Is that fine? So it will go back here, then 55 again 55 will be loaded after AA. Then again A will be loaded into 51, then L call delay, again AA will be loaded into this port 1, then L call delay, then again S jump back. Okay, so this process happens continuously. Is that fine? That is what we wanted. So this 55 is nothing but whenever I am loading this 55, this two lines 55, whenever I am loading into port 1, that means that all the even numbers are even bits of port 1 are being in on condition. Okay, because the binary value, you know, just convert that into binary. So what is the value you are loading into that port 1, which bits are set and which bits are in reset condition. Same way, whenever you load AA into port 1, these two lines, after giving certain delay, that means you are loading, you are just making it opposite of 55. Okay, 55 means you get 010101, AA means you get 10101010, opposite of that. That means before these were in on condition, okay, and this were in off condition. Now when I send AA, whichever were on before, that will become off, okay, and whichever were in off condition will become on. That is what that is the reason I am sending these values here. Okay, instead of this I can also use bit addressable, but that will become lengthy, each bit I need to send every time. Instead I sent 55 and AAH. Okay, so I called a delay after this. After calling a delay, this process should be repeated continuously. So I am writing short jump. And where should I jump? After loading this AA and calling delay, again 55 should be loaded, right? So at this line, I am writing that target address back. Okay, the label I have written over there. Now, we will see the delay program. How this delay works, okay. So, see, delay is, I have written at this, it starts from this location, ORG 300. So here, delay means, see, here I have written move. I can take any register here. I loaded R5 with 0FFH. Okay, 0FFH. Is that fine? Next, what I'm going to do is I have written DJNZ. Okay, that means this FF will be decremented by 1. For example, if you convert this into decimal, that is nothing but generally, if you consider 0, 255 times it will count. Okay. So, see, now this is 255 if it is in decimal. If you take in hexa, take it in hexa FF, whatever. But decrement by 1. Decrement by 1 means first decrement by 1 R5, and here I have written some label again. Okay. So, you can write any label, whatever it is. So, again, that means this whenever it will see this instruction, whatever is there in R5 has FF now. Okay. So, that will be decremented by 1. So, when it decrements by 1, that will become FE. That means in decimal, if you take 255, will become 254. Okay. When it becomes 254, JNZ. So, it will check whether this R5 is equal to 0 or not, JNZ means. Okay. If it is not equal to 0, only then it will jump. So, presently R5 is equal to 254. That means this is not equal to 0. When this 254 is not equal to 0, that means it should jump to this place. Where it is jumping? It is jumping again to the same line, DJNZ. Okay. So, when it jumps to this DJNZ, again presently R5 is equal to 254, right? Okay. So, now decrement. Again, it will see this DJNZ R5 means decrement by 1 again. So, 254 will become 250. I will write it here. Yeah. Now two before it was 255. Next it was 254. Now this 254 will become 253. After it becoming, this was not equal to 0. Yeah. When it became 253, here again this will check whether R5 is equal to this. These are R5 values for every loop. Okay. So R5 is equal to, presently R5 is equal to 253. So 253 is also not equal to 0. When this is not equal to 0, that it is satisfying the condition. Jump if no 0. Okay. So it is again jumping back to this same line, again in the line DJNZ. So DJNZ means presently R5 is equal to 253. So D means it will decrement by 1. 252, it becomes 252 because it decremented by 1. After that, jump if no 0. So this is not equal to 0. When this is not equal to 0, it satisfies the condition and it will jump back to this location again. Okay. So again DJNZ means now this is decremented by 251. In that way, it keeps on decrementing and it will compare whether it is equal to 0. You keep on getting not equal to 0. Till when will you get? You will get up to till this is decremented up to 1. Okay. The next time when you get 0 here, because when you get 1, when R3 is equal to 1 and when you see this DJNZ, it will again decrement to 0. So when this is decrement to 0, okay, then 0 will be equal to 0. At that time, this will not satisfy the condition. When this is not satisfying the condition, you can see a return here. Okay, from subroutine always to return, you will write a return instruction. So it will directly return to where it called. This delay, when it is called, whenever this is the first time I call delay. Okay, so here from 255 to till this 0, till it keeps on decreasing 1 by 1. So it is creating some delay by doing this. Okay, so this is called delay program. So if you wanted to create more delay, then you can using registers. Okay, you can also create a delay using TMOD and all. If you wanted to create a more delay with registers, you can take two registers loaded with FFH. Okay, so you can take those both. First one register you can load with FF, then second register you can load with FF. What you can do is, I'll just give you a small logic. You can practice that delay program on your own. Okay, if you understand this, even this you can understand. So what you should do is, first you should decrement this FF the time. See, this you have 255th time, right? This time you should decrement this up to 0. Okay, from FF to 0, 0 it will count. After counting this, next time what happens is, this FF, you should decrease FF to FE. That means 255 to, see, you are taking two, you are loading just two registers with 255. First time, this register will be decremented to 0. I mean, this many times it keeps on loops. After that, when you get 0, it will go back to this place again. Okay, so that then what happens, at you should write in a such a way that this 255 should be decremented to 254. Okay, 254. When it becomes 254, 254th time, again this register will be loaded with 255. Again 255 to 0, it keeps on, this process will happen. Okay, for 254th time. Next, after that, when it becomes 0, again it will come back to this position. So at this position, again DJNZ, it will decrement 254 with 253. Now 253rd time, this process continues. Okay, till 0. Again next time, this register will be reduced to by 1. In that way, this process will continue 255 times. You are understanding? If you take one register, only one time you can count from 2, you can decrement from 255 to 0. Only if you take one register. If you take two registers, this 255 to 0, you can, this process, this loop continues 255 times. Each time, this goes on. That means it is creating more delay. So try to find out this logic. Try to write that logic on your own. Yeah. Now, so whenever I call this delay, that much delay it created. So till that much time, whenever it is keeping on decrementing and it is checking for the register, again decrementing, checking the register. So see, at that moment, that line is here itself. It is roaming here itself. Okay. It is repeating and wasting its time. That is nothing but it is creating a delay. So whenever that it is repeating in this line, port 1 will be equal to 55 itself. Okay, that means only even number of bits in port 1 will be in on condition and odd number of bits in port 1 will be in off condition. Okay, till how many times it repeats, till that much time it will be in this condition itself. Then this delay will be created. After this delay, when R5 reaches to 0, then it will automatically return, because here there is a return instruction. Okay. So it will return back to this point. We have already seen subroutine how it works. Okay, from a program counter it will store on a stack pointer, then from a stack pointer it will load on to the program counter later. Okay, we have seen this push and pop instructions. So after that AA will be loaded. Now delay was created, okay, 255 times. It was wasting its time by repeating in the same line. This same line it was repeating and it was wasting the time where we created a delay. Now after this delay, now P1 will be equal to AAH, okay, in this line. After that again I'm L call delay, again I'm calling delay. Now from here again it will jump to this delay location. Okay, before from here it jumped, after creating a delay, when delay was over it returned back to this AA line. Now when port 1 is loaded with AA, this will call a delay again. Now same this delay, I mean this line keeps on repeats 255 times. When it repeats 255 times, when it reaches 0 again, it will see this return instruction. So again from here it will jump to this S, jump back. Okay, so that means it was repeating in the same line and it was wasting the time. So that means it is creating some delay. So after this delay it will come back to this S jump. Whenever it will see this S jump, from here the label is here, okay, where we need to jump is we need to repeat continuously, we need to send this 55 and AAH, we need to toggle the port 1. So again we should from here it will jump to this location. Is that fine? So this is the program all about. Next we'll see an example for LED blinking. First see how to interface a LED. See, if you consider this one LED, you can consider port 1, port 2, port 3, whatever it is. If they mention in your question, consider port 1 or 2, you should consider only that port. But in this, they didn't mention any question. So, for example, I have taken port 1.0 here. Okay. See, this is port 1.0. Near port 1.0, I have connected this LED. Is that fine? So, when I connected this LED, LED can be... Excuse. Yeah, this LED can be connected in, you have common anode method and common cathode method. Okay, that means in it. For now, just see how to interface this LED. First, we'll see, you have already learned the characteristics of this LED. See, whenever, if you want this LED to be in on condition, okay, if you want this to be in on condition, what you do is you should connect this to positive terminal and this negative terminal. Okay, so now this is called forward bias. Okay, when it is in forward bias, only then your current passes here and your LED glows. Is that fine? See, here this is anode and this is cathode. This anode should be connected to this positive terminal and this cathode should be connected to this negative terminal, and this is said to be in forward bias, then your LED will blink. Is that fine? Now when coming to reverse bias, see, this is in reverse bias, LED will be in off condition, it won't glow. That because in reverse bias, what we do is we connect anode to this negative terminal and cathode to this positive terminal. So current won't pass here. Okay. So when it doesn't pass in this, that means your LED doesn't glow. Is that fine? So always anode side you should have a higher potential than a cathode side. Is that fine? When you give a higher potential at anode than the cathode, then your LED will be in on condition. So here, see, in this case he has connected this cathode to P1.0 and here he has given a supply, okay, this the anode side. So now for this program, how we need to write. First, we have interfaced this LED to this 8051 controller to a port 1.0. That means in a program we should use this port 1.0. Okay. So whenever I do that, and this program is about blinking single LED. Okay. Before we saw toggle of port. Now we are seeing only toggle of one bit in that port. That is 1.0, where we connected a LED. Okay, so now this should be on and off condition. So to on this, what I need to do is it should be in forward bias. So if this should be in forward bias, then I need to send P1.0 should be made equal to 1. Yeah, see, if this should be in forward bias, then P1.0 should be equal to 0. Okay, for forward bias, because see, this is cathode, here you should have lesser potential than this. Okay, so here you have higher potential. So by making this, this will be in forward bias and this LED will glow. And toggle means on and off, right? So in this condition, when P 1.0 was 0, this was in on condition. Now next, I wanted to off that. To off that, I need to send P 1.0, I should make P 1.0 equal to 1. Okay, so this cathode will have higher potential now compared to anode. So that means, so that means now at this, whenever I send P1.0 with 1, then my LED will be in off condition. Okay, are you getting my point? So in this way it works. P1.0, whenever I make this port 1.0 as 0, LED will be in on condition. Whenever I make this port 1.0 as 1, this will be in off condition. Okay, so now for that you need to write a program, and while on and off, you should always give a delay in between. Okay, because you can't identify whether it is being on and off. You can't, in some microseconds of time this happens. So you need to identify whether it is being on or off. So for that you need to write a delay program, and separately, and you can call it by using a subroutine. Okay. See, in this case, the program we started at 000h location, and in the first case I said to on my LED, I need to make P1.0 is equal to 0. So for that I can, for this is bit, okay, single bit operation, that means I can use CLR instruction. So clear P1.0 means whatever was there in port 1.0 before, that will be equal to 0. Now after that, in this case it will become, this LED will be in on condition whenever I make this as 0. So for that I have written clear P1.0. So this is on condition of LED. After on, before offing this LED, I need to call a delay. So here I have written a call delay. So this delay program, same as in we just saw. Okay, the delay program, you just write it. Okay, take some register and load that with 256 or whatever it is. If you wanted more delay, take two registers and load it and write it. So once it counts, it in that line it keeps on wasting its time. Then once it's done, it will return back to, from here it will return back to this line next. Okay, so now here I have written set B P1.0. That means set B means I am making P1.0 is equal to 1. So when this is equal to 1, this will be in off condition. Okay, here it is off condition, here this is on condition. After that again I am calling a delay. Okay, so again it will jump here, this location. After that it will follow this line, so it will create a delay. After that again it will return to S jump loop. So this LED blinking, again this is continuously. If you wanted it only for once, here no need of writing this S jump loop, you can directly end it by writing end. Okay, but you wanted to continuously blink this LED. Okay, so for that reason I am writing S jump, short jump, some label you give. Okay, last time they have given again or back or whatever it was. So this time they have given loop. And after this, where it need to, again it need to clear, again I need to make P1.0 as equal to 0. So I need to jump to this clear. Okay, so in this way this program works. So whenever I call delay, this is a delay program where I have written separately. Okay, ORG, write at some 300-400 location, wherever you want. So when you understand the interfacing easily, then all the programs will be very easy. You should know the programming and the interfacing, how you are connecting, how it works. When you know that, then it will be very easy to understand. So this is for port 1.0. If you take port 1.2, then instead of here 1.0, you should write port 1.2. You should on it and off it. Okay, now this you are doing by checking this interface. Interfacing is very important. Okay, depending on this interfacing only you are writing a program. You can't blindly write the same program for all the interfacing. Okay, for example, here instead of interfacing my LED in this way, if I interface it in, and here if I use some supply, okay, this is supply. Yeah, so when I do in this way, that means, see this here, if I take port 1.2, if I interface in this way, the same, if I write the same program, then it will be wrong, because if I want to on this LED, just check if it is in this way, it should be in forward bias, means I should give, yes, this is the forward bias condition. That means whenever I want to on this LED, I need to give here 1. Okay, whenever I give here 1, then this anode will be at higher potential than cathode. Okay, so then this LED will be in on condition. When I give instead of that, if I want to on this LED, so that time I need to give here 0. Okay, if I want to off this, when I give here 0, that time anode's potential will be lesser than the cathode. Cathode side will have higher potential. Then this will be in reverse bias condition. Okay, so at that point the program works in this way. For that even this was deleted. Yeah, if I give in this way VCC here, yeah, see for this connection your program will be it will be same, but here instead of clear you will have set B. Okay, here instead of set B you will have clear for this interfacing. Okay, so your interfacing also matters. You need to check your interfacing, and yeah, here which port it is. If you take 1.2, then here it will change from 1.0 to 1.2. Even here it will change from 1.0 to 1.2. Else, if you write some other bit of this port, then the value will be loaded in other bit, not in this bit. So it won't work. Okay, so whenever you are interfacing, check the port bit wherever you are connecting it and the way you are connecting it. So that you can, using that you can write a program. Okay, is that fine? This is an application for LED blinking. Yes, now we have 7 segment display. So this 7 segment display is nothing but, see, we just saw an LED. Okay, interfacing of LED. 7 segment is nothing but here you have 7 LEDs. Okay, and 7 LEDs. See, in this you can see, right, in this you have 7 LEDs, in this 7 LEDs, where you can connect them in both the ways. One is common cathode method, one is common anode method. Is that fine? So this common cathode and common anode is nothing but the thing what I just said you, the way you interface it to your LED. Common means all cathodes are commonly connected to ground. Anode means all anodes are commonly connected to VCC. Okay, because anode should always be at higher potential, so that is connected to VCC. And cathode always it should be at a lesser potential than anode. Okay, to on the LED, so that is connected to ground. See here, for common cathode you have 7 LEDs, and the 7 LEDs or the 7 segment display is nothing but, if you see your calculator, if you see your LEDs and all, see in that screen you will have in this way. Okay, in this 8th position, in this 8th manner. By this you can write all the alphabets and all the numbers. is that fine? So by this you can make it as 0. If you want this to be you wanted 0 to be displayed, then this will be in on conditions. Only this LEDs will be in on conditions. The between this LED won't be in on condition. Whereas if you want to write 7, then only this LEDs will be in on condition. Rest all will be in off condition. If you want to write 8 means all LEDs will be in on condition. If you want to write 1 means only this 2 LEDs will be in on condition. Okay. So for that you just he has taken an orientation. See, whatever orientation you are writing, the same orientation you should write it in your column. Okay. Yeah, so here we were discussing about so this he has just taken to verify, I mean for each LED he has given some name. See, this is A, this LED is A, this is A, this is B, C, D, E, F, and this is G. Okay, so in this manner he has taken even here A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Okay, is that fine? So by this you can easily identify when this, when your 7 is being displayed on a screen, that means your LED A, LED B and LED C are in on condition, rest all are in off condition. Okay, when you are writing this 1, your LEDs E and F, E and F are in on condition, rest all are in off condition. When you are writing 8, A, B, C, D, E, F, G all are in on condition. Okay, and when you are writing 0, except this G, all will be in on condition. So while writing the table of form, you just name it. Okay, this in one orientation, whatever orientation you are writing, you take that in your table of form. Okay, is that fine? So now you have seen this common cathode or common anode. Okay, you can consider anything. You'll in the end you'll end up with the same result. So when you consider, see here the table of form is given. See in this here generally you have another LED. Yeah, see here, can you see this? Okay, this will represent whether it is common anode or common cathode. Okay, so to see that whether it is a common anode or common cathode, so in this total you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 LEDs. Okay, 1 H, this you have taken A, B, C, D, E, F, G, this is H, this is another LED. Okay, in common cathode and common anode. If it will be 1 or 0, depending on that, this LED we can say whether it is common anode or common cathode. See, in this, whenever if I want to write 0, whenever that H, the last one you had H, right? See here you had H, right? Whenever this was equal to 1, then that is considered to be a cathode, common cathode method. Okay, and whenever this is equal to 0, then that is considered to be a common anode method. So in this case, see that that is what here DP, he mentioned it as DP. Okay, or instead you can also write as H. So this in this method all are 1, in this he considered common cathode method. So all are 1s, that means see, if to display the number 0, this he has written in hexa, and for hexa all we need to write in this method, right? So for 0, that means see, this is A, B, C, D, E, F and this is G. Okay, and H is always equal to 1 here, this part, for common cathode method. In common cathode, I am writing 0. 0 means C, A, B, C, D, E, F. All this should be actually equal to 1. Okay, in which method? In common anode method. Just look here properly. When you are taking common, I said we are taking common cathode. So when you are taking common cathode, just check here. See, this is common cathode. Okay, and this is common anode. See how they are connected to your port. see in this way, and this is in this all common anodes are connected to common this VCC. Is that fine? So by this you know when it is forward bias and when it is reverse bias. So in that case, in this common cathode, see if this was your port 1, I am just writing one LED as example. Take one A LED, okay, this A LED, and this LED is connected to port, okay. Common cathode means anode is connected to this port, okay. All cathodes are connected together, okay. So this anode means when this is connected to this anode, and this should be in on condition. When you want this to be in on condition, always you should give this is equal to 0, okay. When you give that is equal to 0, only then you will get this LED will be in on condition. Is that fine? A, B, C, D, E, F. Next, this is only one single LED, A I have taken. Same way B, C, D, E, F and G. Okay, we take all these. Here I have a small doubt. Yes, so here, so common cathode, in this common cathode, this was all the, if you take, let me draw this completely. If you take this as a port, so you have A, B, C, D, E, F, okay. So for this all you have the common cathode is in this way, okay. So on up to the last LED you have all the LED, 7 LEDs, all these cathodes are taken, okay. All these cathodes taken and connected to ground. So if you want this to be in on condition, you should make this as 0, the port whatever, if this is port 1.0 that should be equal to 0, if it is port 1.1, because anode side the ground, okay, it is compared to this ground means the negative potential. So here you are giving 0, that means anode has higher potential than this ground. Is that fine? So when it is anode is at higher potential, that means this will glow. So here I am giving all zeros to on all the LEDs. So what if I want to on first this number? So this you got it right, how to do the connection. All in cathode, all the cathode terminals are taken and grounded, and to on that LED we need to give 0 at anode side, okay, this port wherever anode side, whatever port we connect, that we need to on. I mean giving 0 we can on that LED. If it is common anode, then cathode is connected to this terminal and anode is given to supply, okay, the positive terminal. Anode, all anodes are commonly connected and given to supply. So that means when anode is at higher potential, cathode should be at lower potential, right? So so that cathode what we connected to ports, okay, that you need to make it as 0 in that case. So for now we are dealing with common cathode method, just learn one, the other is opposite of that, okay. So this will be easy. This way it is interfaced. For my this is 8051, to this 8051 all the 7 LEDs are interfaced in this way. Common cathodes are taken and given to ground. Here to make this LED on, you should give at that port 0, whatever LED you want to make, you want to on this LED, then make it as 0 here, okay. So for that, now if you want to on, you want to write a 0. So 0 means this A, B, C, D, E, F. So the only this LED should be on, okay. G should not be on, and for a common cathode H is always equal to 1. So this is always equal to 1, this line I am talking about.
So now A, B, C, D, E, F, C. A, B, C, D, E, F, all I made 0. Then this G is equal to 1. That means this is in off condition and all are in on condition. So then the you can see the 0 value on your display. Next, when I want to on 1 means you can on by using this. Okay, here B and A. So that means B and so this is A, this is B and this is C. Okay. So this by oning this both you will get 1 in this way. So only B and C is equal to 0. Remaining all are 1s. So by that you can get 1. So for this hexa value he has written in this way. Okay. For this the hexa C 1 1 1 0 0, that is C here. Next 0 0 0 is 0. Before alphabet he has just mentioned a 0, that's it. Next this is all 4 ones means F 9. In that way he has written. Next if you wanted 2. 2 means C only you can on G, E, D, B, A. Sorry, I am talking about 2. 2 means A, B, D, E, G. That means see this is A, B, then G also will be there. Okay, A, B, C, D, E. So E and D. This you will get from. You will form 2. So this and this should be in on condition, rest should be in off condition. So according to that he has written. Next if you wanted 3, okay, when you wanted 3, so same way, in this way you will get 3. So only this 2 will be in off condition, so that only this both will be equal to 1. That means F and E will be equal to 1 in 3 KC, F and E. Okay, by default this is 1 always for common cathode. Next see if you want 8, coming to 8, all should be in on condition. That means all we are making it as 0. We have that ports. Next, if you wanted 9, 9 means you should write, see this also will be equal to 9. Only this one won't be in on condition. So this one should be, this we should make it as 1, E is equal to 1. Okay. So if you take 5, so 5 means you should write in this way. So only this and this, B and E will be equal to 1. See B is equal to 1 and E is equal to 1. Okay, so just see the values and verify through that. You just make this, give your own orientation. If you start writing A from here, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, then according to this you need to write this tabular form. You can't write one orientation here and you can't butterfly this table and you can't write some other orientation here. Whatever you are interfacing with your LED, that need to be mentioned in your this tabular form. By that your values will be on condition, because now you have loaded these values. Now what if I wanted to write a program to display all these values? You need to write this in hexa values. These hexa values need to be loaded by writing a program. How will you write a program? Same like here. Okay, in this how did you write a program? The same way there you will write a program by, see here you have written in this, in using 1 bit, but see here what you will do is here you can load a complete port 1 with this value. Complete a port 1 with this value. Okay. If you write C0H, that means your port 1 will be equal to completely this. That means ELED, FLED, ELED, DLED, C, B and A. This will be in on condition. This both will be in off condition. Okay, see whenever I say this H is equal to 1, that means in practically that LED will be in off condition for common cathode method. So that is the reason here it is 1. Okay, and so remaining for common anode, it is just opposite of this. If you wanted to on those LEDs, instead of in place of zeros, all you will get 1s, and place of 1s, all you will get zeros. Okay, so in that way you get it. Yeah, next when you want to write 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, same way you will write it using this program. A program is here. See, for this 8051, you have connected this 7 segment display here. Okay, so on this I wanted to display the different values. See, he has written a program for all the 10 values, okay, 0 to 9. So for that once he moved that with PC, you can directly move here, or else you can move into accumulator and you can write. But if you move each time into accumulator and write, your program will become 10 lines more. So he directly moved P1 with so and so value, then he called a delay. After this, it will jump to delay. It will give some delay. After giving some delay, then it will come back to, after seeing this return, it will come back to the next line. Then F9, that means 0, 1, 2, 3. Call, again call delay, then other value it will show. Okay, here first 0 it will show. Next 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, but for every in between you have a delay before. Because if you don't have a delay, you can't identify which is being on. First 0, 0 will be in on condition. After that 1 will be in on condition. So you can see all LBAs are in on condition. Because that you in that minimum gap of delay you can't identify it. So in that way you kept on see, write a value then call a delay, write the other value, call a delay, write the other value, call a delay, again you load the other value to P1, call a delay. In that way you'll keep on do, and if you want to do that continuously, write this S jump and write that label as here, because after 9 again I'll call 0. After it completed 2, count 0, 1, 2 up to 9, again I'll call 0, 1, 2, 9. So continuously this repeats. If I want to count only once, okay, then here I'll not write loop, instead I'll write here loop. That means this is a terminating line. In this line only it keeps on repeats. Okay, else instead of this line you can also write END, end. Okay, is that fine? So this is all about your LED. Okay, interfacing of this LED, how to write a program for that. In this 7 segment display you have common cathode and common anode method. See, 7 segment display, even this is very important. So common cathode and common anode, and here you have the values have you read. This is they have given it for common cathode. Okay, next this is your LED, same LED 7 segment display, where you have connected it to these 7 segment each LED, and you have written a program depending on that. So by this we'll end our session. Thank you.